Hey, boo, it's Beverly, your favorite girl from Brooklyn. So we're going to jump right into this mask. We're not even going to waste any time. So what you're going to need is an avocado, about half avocado. You're going to need one egg. I have pumpkin seed oil instead of olive oil, but use what you have in your house. What you couldn't really see because I just didn't show you was a banana. You're going to need aloe vera, at least just half of the plant or a quarter of it. You really don't need that much because it makes enough for the mask. So I wouldn't even recommend that much. And of course, you're going to need honey. So let's get right into it. And I'll tell you about the benefits of everything while we're into it. Okay. So number one, obviously, like I mentioned, you're going to need an avocado, about half of it. Avocados, if you don't know, are extremely moisturizing and nourishing because it contains a lot of good fats that are just a godsend for dry, dehydrated and struggle hair, sis. It also nourishes your scalp and it helps your hair look hydrated and healthy. Avocados are the goat for stopping breakage. Now, please do not judge me with my cutting skills, etc., etc., etc. As I mentioned, I am still an amateur and I was just not gonna do another take and waste food. I was just not doing it. So anyway, you want to drop that, you know, suck it right into your blender. I try to use this cute little blender, but as y'all gonna see, there's a whole bunch of bloopers left in. Next are bananas. Bananas are rich in potassium, vitamins, and natural oils. What that means is it moisturizes your scalp, promotes hair elasticity, makes your hair shinier and manageable, and it protects against split ends and breakage. Basically, it smooths out that frizzy hair, sis. Go into the honey because honey is bomb for moisturizing, y'all. What it does is it pulls the moisture from the air and it locks it into your hair for added hydration. Dope, right? I know. So whenever you want to moisturize your hair and lock that moisture in, let's say you get some good moisture in, you want to lock that in with some honey. Anyway, if you're wondering what I'm doing right now, I'm literally just trying to look at my notes for whatever reason. Like I said, I'm still amateur at this, y'all. Bear with me. Subscribe to the channel. And then the more you watch, the better these videos are going to get. And you're going to get all the tea. So next is aloe vera, which is the star of the show. As you know, aloe vera is all about scalp health, okay? While this protein mask is just powerful and it's good for anti-breakage, let's talk about the benefits of aloe vera. Aloe vera has enzymes that repairs dead skin cells on your scalp. It promotes hair growth. It prevents itchy scalp, reduces dandruff, any conditions your hair might have. And basically, it has antibacterial and antimicrobial properties. So what that means is it balances the pH of your scalp. It keeps that scalp nice and fresh. It just keep your scalp conducive for growing just thick, beautiful, luscious hair. One thing I just want to mention, because I didn't even tell you guys, again, you know, bear with my amateur behind, is that this video is all about my recipe for this powerful anti-breakage and moisturizing protein avocado and aloe vera mask that I make to hydrate, strengthen, and help my hair grow shiny, healthy, and fast. Next, what you want to do is you want to use an egg. An egg is rich in protein. It repairs your hair. It improves your hair's texture. It adds shine. And then pumpkin seed oil. So let's just get right into pumpkin seed oil. Here's why I like it. It's non-comedogenic. And while I love my hair, this girl is not playing about her face, so I don't want nothing that's gonna clog my pores. Nope, I do pumpkin seed oil because it's non-comedogenic, it's moisturizing AF, it increases hair growth, boosts healthy hair and shine. And did I mention that pumpkin seed oil was clinically proven to increase hair growth? So if I didn't say this before, I'm a lazy natural. I like to make things quick, fast, and easy. So you're just gonna take everything and blend it. As you can see, this cute little Hamilton Beach blender that I got from Amazon, I'm calling y'all out. While it's adorable, like a lollipop, it don't work, okay? I got this trying to be cute for the tube, trying to show up for y'all so that I could look like I really am this organized in real life. But no, I'm not this organized, and no, everything doesn't match. Hence why, you know, the belt doesn't match on my robe. But don't at me and don't judge me, because I'm sure you lost your the belt to your robe too, And yeah, like, period. And you don't want to be walking around with no open robe. So I'm just saying. But back to the point, I went back to my trusty ninja. So listen, all isn't lost, because at least I was able to portion control. Because God knows, if I would have just used the ninja, I would have put way too much product in there. And I'm not, I don't know about you, but I'm not trying to waste all my stuff in my refrigerator. I'm just not. But anyway, let's just get to the point. So what you're going to do is you're going to mix all these things together. Duh, the obvious, right? There's so many different ways. I mean, there's some people that like to kind of strain their aloe, all of that stuff. Child, just throw all of that in there, the fibers, everything. I mean, if I could, I'll throw the actual skin, but whatever. You throw it into the blender and you mix it. Pretty straightforward. I'm trying to get everything together now. And my amateur behind just obviously am not showing you the best visuals, but I'm clearly happy because it's working. And look, I'm going to show you exactly how smooth and how wonderful it should be. But when should you use this? You should use this basically when your hair is thirsty, when your scalp is itchy. If you're like me, I like to switch things up. I like to go from straight from time to straight from time to time, usually once every 3 months when I'm trying to clip my ends. So when I am reverting from straight back to curly, I like to use this because it's a protein mask, so it's going to strengthen, moisturize, is anti-breakage, and this is basically what you're supposed to get. This is the texture you're supposed to get. It is so smooth, moisturizing, and it's cooling. So imagine this on your scalp. I'm sorry I don't show you a video of me applying it to my hair and washing my hair, because just being honest with y'all, you know, she just did her hair and I'm not about to wet it again, y'all. I love y'all, but I'm not about to break my hair trying to show y'all what to do. But I will show you in another video of me using this. So what I do typically is I will put it on my head for about an hour, wash it all out with cool water, because you don't want to turn into an Egg McMuffin, with your shampoo, your conditioner, and then voila. Style however way you style. So listen, comment down below, let me know if you like this, let me know if you want to see more of these videos. But obviously the more I do, the better I will get. So please subscribe, like, comment. You know, if any of you guys have some ideas on how I could position my camera better, please let me know, because I don't want to take away from the tea and from the actual value that I'm providing to you guys. But anyway, thank you so much for your time, and take a look at my other videos so you can hear all the tea about how I reverse hair loss, my hair loss in 60 days.